Hello, everybody. Today I thought I'd show you how to use the AWS Textract SDK for Golang because I was looking around on the internet and I didn't find a single example anywhere, which is kind of sad. So I thought maybe I'd help somebody out by showing you how to do this. So first we're going to go over how or what AWS Textract is, and then I'm going to show you a little bit of code and show you how to use it and that kind of stuff. So first off, you can test this out at the at a demo. Or at the demo thing, if you go to the page, whatever, I'm sure you'll find it. You can try Amazon Extract. You can upload a picture and you can just like test it out, see what it is. It works really well. So what it's meant for is to have like documents scanned in documents, so you could more easily get the literally extract the text from those documents. And as you can see, it works really well. You can have it in both ways. You can see right now it does line by line or like text piece by text piece. You can also do it in words. And I'll get back to that later in text because there's like a small caveat that you need to be aware of. As you can see, it works really well. I've tried it on a whole bunch of pictures and it works really well. The only issue I see with it here is here's it says MySQL and it is seen it as MySQU. So that's not very good, but overall it works relatively well, especially if you're using like printed text. It works really well. I'm not sure how well it does with hand like handwritten digits or handwritten characters or whatever, but I'm sure it does well. As you can see, it has a confidence in the response has a confidence syntax for each like a line or word. So you could also filter on that if there's a very, very low confidence. You could, for example, filter it out or do something else with it. So let's get started. If you want to use the Textract SDK, you need to send it a file, obviously. You can do this in two ways. You can either send it a bytes blob, which you could use an image for example. You could use the IOUtil package in Golang and just make it make like an image into a bytes object, or you could use an S3 S3 object, which is yeah. If you you can only use the bytes object for PNG or JPEG format files. If you want to send a PDF, where is it? Here, you can send a PDF. It needs to be in an S3 bucket, so beware of that. I will not show that today, but I might do a video on how to put stuff in S3 buckets later, or like in the future, whatever. As you can see, the response is quite big, but all we really care about right now is just the text, which is what I'll show you how to do. There's a whole bunch of other stuff. That's mainly for when you're using other routes or other functions. Right now, we're going to be using the detect document text, which is for like just documents, right? To just get the text back from documents. You also have the analyze document, which is more for forms or tabular data. Obviously, right now we don't have any tabular data, but if we did, it would with every word or with every like item. It would give you it would give you the position of the cell of the table, so it'd give you the row or the column, which is I think really interesting and really useful if you're obviously if you're ingesting tabular data. But right now we're just going to use the detect text function. In AWS fashion, you can also have some other options. You can do it more delayed, where you can send a whole bunch of, or where you can send an image, and then you can get the results of that back later. I think this is for more bigger files, because that might take a while. You can also do pages and stuff. So we're not going to go over this yet, but you can check this out yourself, obviously. Here we have the detect document text function. Obviously, this takes the detect document text input in typical AWS fashion. This takes a document, which is literally exactly this, just the bytes or an S3 object. Again, exactly the same as this. So let's get coding. First, we need some, actually we need package main, obviously. And then we need some imports, standard AWS imports. Right now, we're not going to deal with credentials or any of that stuff. So you'd want to set those using environment variables, which I'm not going to go over. But I'm sure that if you Google a tutorial on the AWS SDK for Golang, I'm sure you find one. Then we're going to set our Textract session, and we're going to make this a global variable just for ease of use. Textract.textract. Then we're going to do func init, and we're going to initialize our session. Textract session equals textract.new. I'm going to adjust my microphone here for a second. Textract.new session.must session.new session. Then we're going to pass in aws.config, and we're going to do region aws.string, and then EU West 2. Only certain regions have this available. Normally I use Frankfurt, which is EU Central 1, I think. But Frankfurt, unfortunately, doesn't have Textract. I think this is London. But you have Ireland as well in Europe, which is good. Then I have already prepared a picture, a sample, which is the exact same picture I used in the demo. So you have the output here. We'll look at that later. So then we have our main function. And first of all, we're going to convert this image into bytes. So we just do file error equals to ioutil.readfile. We're just going to do sample.png. Obviously, this could be anything. This could be, like, this could literally be any bytes as long as it's a PNG or JPEG. If error is not equal to nil, we'll panic. All right, and then here is the bulk of the load, basically. And it's not a lot. The entire file is only like 45 lines. So it's really easy compared to some other similar APIs or SDKs. Textract session dot detect document text. I don't know why it highlights that. And then we do this textract dot detect document text input, and then all we need here is the document, which is a textract dot document, which contains bytes file, and that's it. That's all it is. So then we do if error is not equal to nil. You could use AWS error for this. In the previous video where I went over the DynamoDB SDK, I did, but you can look this up, all the errors and stuff. I'm not going to do this now because it's obviously very specific, but you could. It's not that complicated. Panic, error. Obviously, if you're using this in production, you might want to handle this a little better, but for now, it doesn't really matter. Then we're going to do, we're going to loop over the result. For I is equal to 1, I is smaller than length of resp.blocks. As you can see, I'll take a look at the thing here. Where is it? The response. Here, output. It outputs blocks, which is exactly this here. So we're just going to loop over that and get everything. Yep. And then I++, our loop. And then I'll get back to this. So if you remember correctly, I said something about this. I don't know why, but you can't select which one you want from your input. So what Amazon has done is it just sends you both. It sends you all the lines and all the words. So in theory, you get everything twice. And as you can see here, that's denoted in the block type. So if you're looping over all your blocks, you need to check whether or not it's of the line type or of the word type. And that's just a string, obviously, but Amazon has, no, never mind, something else. So we're just going to do if resp dot blocks I dot block type capitalized equals equals line. We're just going to print md dot println resp dot blocks I dot text. And that's it. That's it, really. We can test this out. Go run. Document. Yes, please. This should work. It's taking a while. And voila, there we have it. As you look at the picture, here we have everything, and that looks correct. And the same mistake is done as well. So looks like this is something very specific. I'm not sure if it does this on all fonts, but yeah, Amazon, you might want to look into MySQL. If we want to change it to Word, I think is the correct string. You can also do that, and then it should do everything word by word. As you can see, it takes quite a while. I'm not sure how long it takes, but I'm guessing it's a full second almost for it to return. That's why you obviously have the delayed get document analysis, start document analysis, or text detection. And it's and theoretically, it's the same, except I think you get a job ID, and then if you're requesting it, you have to just give the ID, and then it. I think then, if we go back, wait, yeah, hold up, I'm getting confused. go back even more. Then if you get it, then it returns what it returns now, which is just the entire blob. I can print this out for. FMT dot println resp, and then you can see basically all it does. It's really long. It's almost 2,000 lines, and I've copied that over into sample output dot JSON. And here you can see the way it works is I think you can do the dependency yourself, or the relationships or the position. You can do it yourself, but obviously you don't really need to because it's all in the line. But if you were to do it word by word, I think you can. And obviously it tells you where each thing is, the bounding boxes and that kind of stuff, which is really interesting. Obviously not really for this case, but you could use it probably very well. As you can see here, you have the confidence, which is really high. And actually, so it's almost, for almost everything, it's really high, in the high 90s, and for here, MySQU, it's only 76. So yeah, that's it basically. There's plenty of other stuff you can do. I might do another video on the tabular data, but I'm not sure. Also, one thing I wanted to say is that you have the AWS TextTract, and you have AWS Recognition. If you're familiar with the Recognition API, it has the same feature, but the Recognition, as it says here, the Recognition API is more for live scenes or for posters or road signs, and this is really for documents. So this is probably trained on like actual documents, as the Recognition API is probably more trained on some real life stuff. So that's something to keep in mind if you're looking for the right product or that kind of stuff. So I hope you liked it. I hope you understood. This code will probably be on GitHub. If you're too lazy and you just want to copy it over, that's fine. If you like this video, you can always like it. If you have any comments or any of that stuff, if you want me to do a video about a specific Amazon product or about something else, you can always let me know below in the comments. You can follow me on GitHub everywhere. That'd be great. I'll see you guys next time.